This is the smallest elephant on Earth. There are horse breeds taller than this elephant. So, what caused its stunt growth? Is it lack of nutrition or it is other factors? Well, what I found out is even more interesting. This is the same thing happened to the dwarf mammoth in the island of Crete, a factor called insular dwarfism. This is an evolutionary process occurs when large species become smaller over generation due to living in isolated environment with limited resources. Their smaller size also reduces their overall energy requirements, making it easier to survive during periods of food scarcity. And this is what happened to the pygmy mammoth of Crete, as fossil evidence suggests that Crete had limited resources. But if we look at Borneo is an island paradise with abundance. Elephants there have access to food, water, and even mineral salts of all kinds. Southeast Asia as a whole grew a small group of Austronesians into 400 million people today, and the animals are not exception, which is due to their resource abundance. Borneo is paradise, it's the Tahiti of Red Dead, but still the elephants there are pygmies. There is another answer to this, and to get this answer, we have to look at their evolution. Asian elephants, African elephants, and mammoths share a common ancestry, placing them within the order Proboscidea. This shared lineage originates from Africa. Subsequently, evolutionary divergence occurred within the African elephant lineage, Loxodonta, branching off first, and from the remaining lineage, the Asian elephant, Elephas, and mammoth, Mammuthus, lineages then diverged, establishing their distinct evolutionary trajectories. Later, DNA analysis suggests that Borneo pygmy elephants diverged from Asian elephants around 300,000 years ago, during the Pleistocene epoch. Sea levels were much lower due to ice ages, and land bridges connected many islands to the mainland. A population of Asiatic elephants may have migrated into Borneo via these land bridges and became isolated when sea levels rose again. Borneo's dense rainforests and swampy terrains may have favored smaller, more agile elephants that could easily navigate through thick vegetation. Together with fewer large predators on the island, there was less evolutionary pressure to maintain a large body size for defense. So, this explains their small size, but these pressures carved out the most unique-looking Asiatic elephant out there, standing between 8.2 to 9.8 feet tall, are noticeably smaller than their mainland cousins, with a unique charm all their own. Males rarely reach beyond 9.8 feet tall, while females typically remain under 7 feet, making them 20 to 25% smaller than mainland Asian elephants. This makes them easily rideable elephants. It's like riding a Shire or Belgian Dwarf. It's a good thing they weren't domesticated because they are the perfect candidate animal to domesticate. And they weigh between 2,950 to 5,000 kilograms. Their appearance is instantly captivating. Imagine an elephant with an almost baby-like face that persists into adulthood, complemented by distinctly rounder features. Their ears, proportionally larger for their body size, often display unique pink spots and mottlings. What makes them particularly distinctive is their unusually long tail, which nearly touches the ground, and their straighter, downward-pointing tusks, which is male-exclusive. Their skin feels noticeably softer than other Asian elephants, and they've evolved specialized foot pads perfectly suited for navigating the swampy terrains of their homeland, which is found exclusively in the Malaysian part of northeastern Borneo. primarily in Sabah State and Kalimantan, occupying a mere 5% of Borneo's vast landmass. They make their home in lowland rainforest, river valleys, and swampy areas, where they've adapted specifically to these forest types, which leads to their behavior, which sets them apart from other elephant species. Known for their notably gentle nature, they show remarkable tolerance towards human presence and rarely engage in cooperating except for lustful, hunger-driven solitary males. Their social structure is fascinating. They form intimate family groups of 8 to 12 individuals, smaller than typical elephant herds, led by a wise matriarch. Males in these groups often stay with their families longer than observed in other elephant population. But gradually, they'll eventually leave the herd to join a bachelor herd until they become mature enough for solitary life, where they'll only join a female herd when it's time to get freaky with the ladies. But other than that, female herds display unusual social bonding with non-family members. Their communication is unique too, with vocalizations specific to Bornean populations. Their reproductive patterns also differs from mainland elephants, with shorter gestation periods, earlier female maturity, and higher birth rates in wild populations. Even their mating calls follow different patterns, adding to their distinctiveness. They usually live up to 55 to 75 years. This is possible because of they are K-selected species, meaning they have a slow rate of reproduction, long gestation periods, and extended periods of parental care. B is their diet. These guys are herbivorous. And as herbivorous, their diet is impressively diverse, encompassing over 300 plant species, and easily accessible. They show particular preference for certain palm trees that their mainland relatives avoid, and remarkably can digest toxic plants that other elephants wouldn't dare touch. Their role in the forest ecosystem is crucial. They act as essential dispersers of rainforest fruits, helping maintain the forest biodiversity. With only about 1,500 individuals remaining, these elephants face significant challenges. Classified as endangered by the IUCN Red List, they battle against habitat loss from deforestation, encroaching palm oil plantations, poaching for their stray tusks, and human-wildlife conflicts. Luckily, conservation efforts are ongoing, with organizations like Wild Wildlife Fund or WWF and local governments working tirelessly to protect these remarkable creatures. These efforts include establishing wildlife corridors, implementing anti-poaching measures, and educating local communities. Their preservation isn't just about saving a species, it's about maintaining the delicate balance of Borneo's rich ecosystem, where these gentle, intelligent creatures play an irreplaceable role. And another gentle giant is the largest monkey, the drill. Feel free to have a watch, and as always, stay curious, stay wild, and thank you very much for watching.